This is Tom and Paula Grace from Light of Christ Radio.
And we are here with a story that we hope will give you and your group light for the journey. Instructions for leading your small group can be found below in the Show More section.
We'll give you the context of the story and then tell the Bible text as a story.
As you listen, try to put yourself in the story. Listen carefully as you will be asked to retell the story after hearing it.
Don't try to read the text along with the video. Simply watch and listen. We have found that by listening and retelling the story before reading the text, you will give God space to speak to you through the story.
Today, we continue our series, God Has More, with the story of Elisha and the Arameans from 2 Kings 6.
We have seen how God has more for us in our calling. He gave Moses a second chance. Peter was just a common fisherman, yet he became a leader in the early church. And Paul, a Jewish theologian, became a missionary to the Gentiles.
Now we'll spend a few weeks exploring how God has more for us in prayer. Elisha had trained under Elijah and now was a prophet to the king of the northern nation of Israel.
Even though many people of Israel, including the king, were worshiping idols, God had sent his prophets to demonstrate who he was. The Arameans are attempting raids on the nation of Israel, and God in his mercy was warning his people.
And this brings us to a story from the Word of God. Aram's king had waged war against Israel, and he gave these instructions to those who served him. I want my war camp at this particular place.
But immediately, the man of God sent a message to Israel's king. Be sure not to travel through this place. The Arameans are on their way. Israel's king passed this warning on to those in the place the man of God had told them about. Elisha's warning saved Israel's king more than a few times.
And Aram's king became greatly angered by this. He gathered his servants together and asked, which one of you has betrayed me and sided with Israel's king?
The servants replied, it is none of us, my lord and king. The prophet Elisha, who lives in Israel, is the one who informs Israel's king of these things. Elisha somehow knows everything you say, even the secret things you whisper in your private chambers.
And so the king commanded, find Elisha right away so I may capture him.
The servants found Elisha and informed Aram's king, Elisha is in Dothan. So Aram's king dispatched a great army of warriors along with many horses and chariots, and they encircled the city of Dothan at night.
Elisha's servant woke up and early and went outside. There he saw a great army along with many horses and chariots encircling Dothan. And the servant said, oh, master, what are we going to do now?
Elisha replied, have no fear. We have more on our side than they do. Then Elisha began to pray, oh, Lord, I ask you to allow my servant to see heavenly realities.
And the Lord opened the servant's eyes so that he could see, and this is what he saw. The mountain was covered with horses and chariots of fire surrounding Elisha.
When the enemy approached Elisha, he prayed, O Lord, I ask you to blind these people.
And the Lord blinded them, just as Elisha had requested. And then he went out to the army and said,
you are wrong. This is the wrong path and the wrong city. I will lead you to the person you are really after.
Elisha then led them to Samaria and the king. And Elisha prayed as they all arrived in Samaria.
O Lord, I ask you to allow these men to see. So the Lord opened their eyes so the men could see. This is what they saw. They were in Samaria.
And the king of Israel saw them and said to Elisha, do you want me to slaughter these men, my father? Shall I kill them all?
Elisha replied, no, do not slaughter them. Would you really slaughter men whom you have captured with your sword and with your bow? Set the table and fill it with bread and water. Let them eat and drink and return to their own master.
Israel's king had the table set and offered the Arameans a great feast. After they ate and drank, Israel's king told them to leave. They returned to their own master, and the Arameans stopped sending raiding parties into Israel. And this is a story from the Word of God.
Now that you've heard the story, try to retell it from what you heard. Then read the text.
Discussion questions are found below this video in the Show More section. Use these to spark some conversation around the story text.
We hope you and your group will learn how God has more for you through these stories.
May you be blessed.